a dream lifter. It's a modified 747. As you said, Donna, our Brenda Washington has made it to Wichita this morning. She's there live with an update. Brenda?
That's right, guys. There's the plane right there. As you can see, it looks like a ghost when you pull up on the highway there. We've got some officials here who'll give us hopefully a few answers this morning. Okay, so I'll be talking with you. And your name, please, and who are you with?
I'm Roger Zanders with Wichita Mid-Continent Airport, Airport Police and Fire.
A couple of questions. Was this a mistake, an emergency? How did the two-man crew end up here at the airport?
Well, as to how they ended up here, I'm not going to speculate. That had to be directed to Atlas Air. And I have that information I'll give to you later in reference to their contact.
How were they able to land safely this short one runway? I know they need at least 9 or 10,000 feet to take off and land. This has about 6,000 feet.
Correct. This runway has 6,101 feet. They were able to land safely and come to a stop at the end of the runway.
What's the plan for getting this plane on its way?
Well, as of right now, the crew will be arriving at approximately around 10 o'clock local time, and then the crew will do their pre-flight and take off for approximately 12 o'clock.
And they will be able to take off safely on this short runway?
Yes, that seems unimaginable,
the size of the plane and the short runway.
Yes, they'll be able to. Atlas Air has assured us that the aircraft will be able to take off safely.
Okay, well, there you have it. It's a very large plane, guys. It looks like a ghost when you drive along the highway and you see it sitting here. But again, as you heard, we're being told that they should be able to safely take off from this airport here, Jabara Airport in Wichita, sometime around noon. From Wichita, Brenda Washington, KMBC 9 News.
Well, as we've been talking about all morning, planes have taken off from short runways before, of course. It's going to be interesting to watch, though, for sure. Atlas Air, by the way, it's out of New York State. It runs a cargo shipping business, basically, for Boeing for its Dreamliner aircraft, and that's why that aircraft is so big. It basically takes Dreamliner parts all around the country. So, wow, what a situation there.
Well, and it's not just the parts. You were saying earlier that it's so big because these are parts that are, many of them, assembled.
Yeah, it's the plane that actually ships those parts to assemble the Dreamliner airplane. So
we're going to stay on top of this story for you here on KMBC 9 News Now.